Fellas, look at that booty. Look at that booty. Maybe in like 4 months.
So do you want to hear some of the most outrageous bullshit ever? Want to hear it? I'm going to tell you. So last night when I ended the vlog on the 14th floor, or I should say floor number 14. Since there's no floor 13, shouldn't you say floor number 14? Because really floor number 14 is the 13th floor. Back to the point. Jumped in my car. Here's something I didn't see before I started driving. I saw it as I was editing the vlog, and of course I saw it 1 minute after I got in my car, but as you can see on this little clip from the end of the vlog yesterday, the damn, so CES is going on, right? It's at Venetian. I don't know if the whole thing is at Venetian or if part of it is at the convention center and part of it is at the Sands convention. I don't know. All I know is there's a shit ton of CES people at Venetian. They're parking at Venetian. Here's the point. The traffic was so backed up getting out of the parking garage. You ready for this one? Sit down before I tell you how long it took me to get my car from the top of the Venetian parking garage to the street where I was actually driving home. 2 hours and 45 minutes. That is the most insane thing ever. Yo, 2 hours and 45 minutes sitting in my car. It was over an hour before I moved 3 car lengths. Finally, miraculously, as I came down the ramp at about the 2.5 hour mark, suddenly, everything started moving from above. They were directing the traffic to go another way. Blah, 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 blah. 2 hours and 45 minutes. I was so pissed. Had I known it was going to take that long, I wouldn't have sat in my car. But at the 1 hour mark, you got to say to yourself, you know, this shit can't take forever. It's got to move at some point, right? Then at the 2 hour mark, I'm like, holy shit, I should have reparked my car and gotten out and gone anywhere besides sitting in my car. Back. Anyway, just want to tell you that story. On a brighter note, even though the rain went away, the air is much cleaner today, much more clear. Everything is much more bright and vibrant, and you can see shit way over there without that smoggy, foggy cloud, you know, looking cloud of dust that always exists here. I'll breathe for you. Go astray but you wanted so much more than that. But you wanted so much more than that. So there was zero chance that I was gonna park at Venetian again, and as a matter of fact, I don't even want to be on that side of the strip. So I parked at Caesars. I think I'm gonna go in here and get some food at Caesars. And then, I think I may play at Venetian again. I guess we'll just wait and see. CES is huge. There are CES people all over town. But Venetian has a lot of games because they're doing the high hand promotion slash splash pot promotion. And that shit is way too loud for a parking garage at this hour. That food was good. Grilled chicken sandwich from Smashburger.
It was good, but did you see how flat they pounded that chicken? I guess they did that so it would cook fast. I don't know. It was all right though. It wasn't bad. Paying with comps usually makes it better, but not for that pizza in the food court. Nothing can make that better. All the Christmas trees in Caesar's Lobby, they gone, man. They gone.
I'm a man of action, but I've been defeated by time.
There seriously is a major difference in the way things look after a good rain. The air is just like so much more clean, so much cleaner. You can feel it and you can definitely see it. I mean, shit looks clean. Look at this. I should have gotten out here earlier today, to be honest with you. It's 2:52. I wish it was noon. I guess I can wish in one hand and, well, you know the rest. Let's check on our New Year's hat situation. Still there. Still there. Looks like the apple might be gone though. Maybe I might stop blowing my horn like that. That's super annoying. Do you think somebody ate that apple? Maybe a homeless? Maybe a crazy person? I mean, the sidewalk is right on the other side of the thing. All right, so I have formulated a plan. Vandalism. Little vandalist ass bitch. So I formulated a plan to get coffee and play poker. Let's execute that plan.
You've always been there in my prime. In my prime. Thanking me for who I was. And
if you've watched my vlog before, you probably figured out what the plan is for coffee and poker.
What I became. I loved you when we were one, and in the darkest night. I loved you when we were one, and in the darkest night. That you wanted so much more.
I mean, let's be honest, if you guessed Starbucks as my plan for coffee, that's not a win. That's not a W for you because that's too easy. But if you guessed that I was gonna come to the Forum Shop Starbucks, I'm gonna give you that W on that. Even though I don't believe in jinxes, I don't wanna jinx this, but I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna say it anyway. Hopefully it doesn't jinx it. But it's been a really long time since I had a Starbucks cup that leaked at the seam. Usually, well not usually, but it used to be like very regular basis. Probably at one point it was 80% of the time the cup would drip on my hand at the seam. I mean, you could always turn, because I'm a little bit OCD on the Starbucks cup. So here's some Starbucks coffee trooper information that you don't know yet. I'm certain I never told you this, but it has to be like this. Let me show you. Actually, we'll call this Trooper Trivia. So, why am I putting it down? I guess I was going to put it down because it's not actually perfect today. But it can be like within like a half an inch or whatever, but check this out.
See the seam on the cup right here? There's only one seam on one side of the cup. That has to line up with the fold in the sleeve, right? Not the seam of the sleeve, a fold of the sleeve. And then I always hold the cup this way. Now, honestly, it doesn't matter if the seam is on this side or this side. It would also could be at this fold in the seam, I mean in the sleeve. And I used to always put it on this side. But then when it started dripping all the time, I would just put it on this side. So if you see like this,
it's not actually dripping on my hand, right? Because this way, it'd be dripping on my hand. And it was like torture. Like the most annoying, like torture, mental torture, physical of ever, right? I guess it would be mental torture because it wasn't torturing me physically. Does this dude know what a crosswalk is? See, this is what you deal with in Vegas. No idea what a fucking crosswalk is, right? Dumb, just dumb. But you know what I will say on a positive note? Cause I tend to be leaning, how you doing? All right, I like your little boots. Oh, stop, trooper. The funny thing is, as much as I love the rain, this post-rain sunny day has actually got me in a good-ass mood. A good-ass mood, like, if I was in a bad mood, I might have kicked a dent in the side of that car for sitting on the crosswalk. But I'm in a great mood, so I didn't. Where you going? So much more than that. Love the weather out here, and as much as I could hang out and walk around and talk nonsense to you guys, I think I'm gonna go ahead and get into a game here at Venetian. I am on the list. I know that's what you're thinking. Trooper, did you call ahead? Oh, I called ahead.
I tried to hold on and stay the night, but you wanted so much more than that.
So today's off to a little bit of a bad start. My first buy-in, I had kings. I made a 10 pre-flop, got one caller. Flop was 993. I checked. I'm out of position. I checked. The guy bet. I call. Turn is a 4. I check. The guy bet. And I called. The reason I'm doing this is because obviously, I'm just repping like overs or whatever. I believe that I would have maximized in this pot by playing it this way. The river was a 5 and I led out for 100 and he went all in for about 100 more. I believe it was 90 more. It was 190. 2, I think. I called and he had pocket 5s. He had pocket 5s. Rivered the old 5 ball, the old 2 outer. It was just unfortunate that it comes that way. That's the first buy-in. Second buy-in went to flopping trips and getting out kicked. And the guy never even made a bet. I bet 75 on the river. He called, the guy who had me out kicked, and pocket aces called. And pocket aces, after betting on the 6-6 deuce flop, after betting and getting 2 callers, and then checking through on the river on the turn, and on the river, I bet 75. Dude calls me who has queen 6 in his hand. Pocket aces actually called 75 on the river. Couple of not so great hands, but you know what's the best way to get over being down 600? $10 juice. Oh man, that's good. This is spinach, kale, spinach, kale, what the hell's in this? Spinach, kale, apple, celery, lemon, And there's one more thing. I want to say carrot, but I could be wrong. Oh, this has cucumber in it. That's right. That's the other thing. It has cucumber. Man, I don't even know. All I know is there's a bunch of vegetables in here, and she juiced it fresh right in front of my face for $9.95 for a big one. This is how big is this? 20-ish? What is that, 18 ounces, 20 ounces? I don't know. Well, this was just one of those days. Doesn't matter how good you are, or who you are, or what you know, or what you think you know, or any of that. Nothing could stop what was in store. My very last hand, I just had pocket 10s pre-flop. I raised a 12, three callers, and the flop was queen 10, six, two hearts. It goes check, I bet 20. The guy after me calls 20. The other guy folds, and it goes back to the big blind who raised a 75. So I think about it for a second, and I just push all my chips in, which was a grand total of about 250, something like that. And the guy after me called all in for 151, and then the other guy pretended to try to figure out how much it was as if he was thinking about calling, which is absurd. He was fucking calling any amount because of his dumbass hand. He called. The turn is a black ace. The river is like a four of hearts. I roll over a set of tens. The dummy in the big blind rolls over queen three of hearts, and the guy behind me had king seven of hearts. So they both made a flush, and I lose my last buy-in of the day, minus 1,000. This is one of those times where, you know, people will be confused. Some of you guys will be confused that I'm not pissed or mad or upset or sad or angry about losing $1,000. There's just nothing that can be done sometimes. The guy with a pair and a flush draw, okay, the guy who called queen three of hearts pre-flop out of position. What you need to be able to win at poker is to have players that will lose money to you. And so these guys are absolutely willing to lose money to me. Sometimes they're gonna get super lucky and hit a crazy card, right? So a quick look at this fucking asshole. Wow, what a bunch of fucking morons. Some people may think it's crazy to bitch about traffic when you're not even driving or even in a car, but you just can't help but notice how fucking dumb people are. It's like they've never driven cars before. So a quick inquiry with a poker odds calculator reveals that my equity in that pot on the flop when all the money went in was 73%. King seven had 25%, and queen three, the guy who check raised the flop, the guy with the pair and the flush draw, was 1.44% to win. I mean, he did win a side pot, but it wasn't that much. So am I saying that they should have folded? Not necessarily, but what I am saying is that they were willing to lose money to me, and they effectively did. So, what do you do? Like, 73% of all that money that was out there. I mean, we could run the numbers on what queen three had against me in the side pot. Let's do that actually. I think he probably had around 25%. So 29%. So that guy had 1.4% equity in the main pot, and he had 29% in the side pot, which was $150. At the end of the day, it was just a shitty day. I guess the point is that The reason I'm not angry or pissed off is because I'm in games with people who are completely overvaluing their hands and who are putting it in super bad and who are just recreational players, especially during CES. So there's nothing to complain about. Like, if I want to quit playing poker today and never play again, that's an option. But obviously, if I'm going to continue to play poker, then I have to be happy about the things that are good and the things that are beyond my control. You can't let it get you down. This is a mindset. Now, let me just say that if I'm short rolled and I'm like almost broke or super scared of going broke or whatever, that's a different story, you know? Then you can be stressed when shit doesn't go your way. But you can't be stressed and pissed off and expect to make it in poker just because shit doesn't go your way sometimes, you know? You know, I do plan to quit poker. I plan to quit poker because I want to do something better. I want to do something more fulfilling, something more fun for me, something more meaningful from my perspective in life. I would like to bring people value instead of just... The only value I might bring right now is just giving someone another opponent at the poker table. I mean, I don't feel like that's all that valuable, you know? That's something that anyone can offer if they just have the minimum buy-in, you know? And I'm pretty sure that that's why this vlog has been more important to me than poker for quite some time. Because I feel like I'm bringing value to everyone who watches. Because it's entertainment. In whatever way you view it, it's entertainment. Until I am in a position to, you know, full on go for the other things that I want to do, I'm going to keep playing poker. Because playing poker is a hell of a lot better than dealing poker or waiting tables or... Alright, some vandalism is a little bit funny. A little bit. Guess what tomorrow is? Trooper Thursday. By the way, this is important. Hopefully, if you're going to Trooper Thursday, you watch this vlog. Because of CES, the Westgate is charging for parking. However, play at least 1 hour of poker and your parking will be validated. If you come play my game, you will not have to pay for parking. If you come play my game, you will not have to pay for parking. So I'm sitting here editing the vlog, and that's the last thing I have. What does that mean? That means I didn't end the vlog. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. Hopefully I'll see you tomorrow, today if you're watching this, at the Westgate for Trooper Thursdays. But either way, I'll see you next time. It's you that I'm seeking when I die.